بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على خاتم الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. السلام عليكم brothers and sisters.
وعليكم السلام.
60 days or 60 nights left in Ramadan, Taraweeh. And I was told yesterday, you know, some people go to the bathroom, open the water, and looking at the mirror or the wonder here and there, and leave the water running. I think that's haram, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indicated in the Quran, إِنَّ الْمُبَذِّرِينَ كَانُوا إِخْوَانَ الشَّيَاطِينَ. Not only haram, they are the brothers of shayateen, those who are wasting. Who are, you know, wasting the water, the resources, food, and so on. If you look at the people of Gaza, even the people in Egypt, and everywhere, you see how much we are lucky to have clean water, to have water, to have everything. And really, tonight I had breakfast here, and of course, every night there is a dinner here, which is really a blessing. I never thought it would be like this. So the social hall was almost full. We have to put more tables. And it is really something to be appreciated, to be in a community who really feel that it is a part of their faith to do something. I don't need to mention about other things, other project here in Toledo, Islamic Food Bank. I was invited, the honor to be invited for the first or second day in Ramadan breakfast in downtown Toledo. And so far, I believe, if I'm correct, more than 1.8 million, right, Dr. Rafiq, or two? 1.8 million dollars spent on food. So this kind of effort, really, we are so proud to have this here in Toledo, Islamic Food Bank. So this is the arena that we should really be competing in. Add to that many other things in town, but what I have seen today really is amazing. May Allah bless the families who are taking care of the whole month. If I have a son or a daughter in a college somewhere in the States, and they have a mosque that they welcome them every night for food, I will be so happy, and I will sit assured that my son and daughter have family to sit with and to eat good quality of food. Thank you, Ways and Means, for doing that. And that is from day one, that chart there on the bulletin board was full, and that is really what they call it, faith in action. That is faith in action. Our salah is only for us, for me as Farooq, for you as Muhammad or Yusuf, for example, you know. And but so my benefit is only for me, but when my faith branches out of my arena, my area, my comfort zone, that is what we need. That is why here in America, especially in Toledo, we are making a difference, because we really know how to make da'wah. This is the way of da'wah. I do not need also to mention, I just before Maghrib, I put it again on the bulletin board, Habitat for Humanity. That is another field that we should get involved. May Allah bless the people or bless their soul, those who died, who used to go for Habitat, you know, for a whole month to build the house for homeless. And they're gonna start, I think, right away in April 4th and April 11th. The clergy used to go to bless the ground, and when the house is done, then they go to bless, to welcome the family and to pray a lot of clergy. And the Habitat suggested to have a day for the clergy. So they go and work together instead of blessing and coming back. So we'll spend the day there. they are very short in volunteers. So please, this is more important than nafl, more important than any other things that, you know, we do. And we think that is a religion, that is Islam. Islam there is real Islam that is visible, that make da'wah. When you are there, a lady with hijab, you know, or wearing jeans and working, cutting wood or nailing, you know, hammering, all of that, or even preparing food, or brothers there, and they get mixed with other people, then we know that Islam is a life, is a living reality. So please look at the bulletin board and try to look for a day or two to volunteer, and we need to be visible there. Sadly, the last two or three houses they built, I go there and I never seen one Muslim there, except one person, may Allah give him full recovery. He was planning to go, but he fell down and he has, you know, his knees broken. He's the only one used to go from the whole Muslim community, from all masajid. Think that is very important. Even if you are a doctor, engineer, whatever, make one day off just to be visible there. I'm sure you're gonna appreciate that. That is what I want to also, water, please, save water, you know, consider the blessing that we have. When I came before Asr, after Dhuhr, here to give zakah to the people who you generously give zakah for, I found 4 or 5 water bottles sitting on the floor there under the chairs. And again, we keep repeating that we need to be more aware of that. As for the khatira, I don't want to upset any of our children or any of our parents. You know, we are in this country, when our children reach a certain age, they start thinking about, you know, their manhood. You know, I think it is very, very important to think wisely about it and to be more kind, to sit with them, more open-minded to sit with them. And I myself never ever seen any problem between somebody in college and getting married, especially here, because haram here is accessible. Haram is widely open, is very inviting, and it is very attractive, and you can see it on your phone. You look at the phone, they offer themselves. So why we do not really make halal accessible to our children, our youth, our young people, men and women? If your son or daughter in the age of marriage, it is very wise to work hard to match them together and to look for a young man for your daughter, and not only that, to encourage them to get married. I been approached by, and when I asked, he said, no, he or she doesn't want to get married. That is not healthy. That is not a good sign. We should really be worried about them. If you know how much Islam encouraged our youth to get married, and yes, he can be a doctor and he will be the best doctor, inshallah. But you cannot deprive him from his right to get married. So when he married, that will never take him away from his study or his research or his career or academy or things like that. To the opposite. And I am a father and a grandfather. I used to encourage my children when they were in high school. And most all of them got married right after 4 years of college, even in high school when they want to. So at least you can have your grandchildren children when you are healthy and you are good, so you can have fun with them. But what is the case gonna be when you become old, you know, and you cannot get up, and you still have, you know, grandchildren, you cannot even run after them. So it is really a good sign the Prophet encouraged youth to get married when they feel too. Even if I'm a father, I can support them financially, no big deal. It is very godly thing to give money for. And I'm willing, you know, to help. I'm trying to really to get our children to get married. When someone asks me, I approach here and there and there. And sometimes you see the answer that they don't want to get married. And so please, you know, if somebody come ask for your daughter's hand or your son is willing to marry, do not make it so difficult for him. Make it accessible. Do not stand, do not, you know, in his face and say, no, I'm worried about your future. The future, inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ What's the rest of the verse? وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهَ So education comes with taqwa. What is the use of my son, you know, after graduating and start his career and start this and that and that, and they want to get a PhD and all of that, and then he will forget about marriage. Sometimes they do that, they forget about marriage. Why? Because busy with their life, you know, practical life and their major and all of that, and they do not think about marriage. And some of them are growing, hair become gray, and over 40, and they don't marry. So I'm very, very worried about them, especially here in America. As I said, may Allah protect all of them. Not all of them, of course, think about haram, but why we don't really shield them and they make them really a comfort for our eyes, make a family, and we can have them in the same house until they finish. And some people do that. Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, when his daughter, Hafsa, become a widow, her husband died, and she became a widow, single again. He was looking for a man for his daughter. That does not affect me as a person, or as a doctor, or as an imam, or somebody in the community. It is very smart to look for somebody who is good. It doesn't matter how rich or poor. No big deal. We can take care of both of them. One can take care of the family. And by the way, if the person suffers any kind of, you know, shortage in money, when he marry, Allah will double his rizq right away. Because Musa alayhi salam, when he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنِّي لِمَا أَنزَلْتَ إِلَيَّ مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَقِيرٍ I am in dire need for the khayr that he made and they give water to the daughters of Shu'aib, then what happened? Right away, فَجَاءَتْهُ إِحْدَاهُمَا تَمْشِي عَلَى اسْتَحْيَا One of the two daughters came, inviting him, and he got married. He has no country, no job, no money, no family. Allah gave him a community to live, a family to live, a wife, and everything. So Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu was offering Hafsa to Abu Bakr. He knows Abu Bakr is married, but get, you know, marry Hafsa. She is a good lady. And Abu Bakr said, sorry. And went to Uthman. Uthman radiallahu anhu didn't answer. He got so mad and he went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to complain. Said, Ya Rasulullah, I offer my daughter to Abu Bakr and to Uthman, and none of them accepted the offer. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, يتزوج Uthman من هي خير من حفصة ويتزوج حفصة من هو خير من أبي بكر وعثمان. So the one who will marry حفصة is somebody not أبو بكر وعثمان is محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. So please for God's sake your children is our children. My children is yours. So discuss it with them. If they feel to go for it and if you need any help I am available. I want really our youth. If you know somebody who want to marry, please give me the name and I get her the name and we can match our children together, inshallah. So I'll be matchmaker, inshallah. So, thank you. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.